Declined is, I mean, it's going to get more tough. In October, in November, we're going to see more mortality. It's a moment that the countries don't want to hear this bad news, and I understand. But I think it's very important that this is going to finish at one moment or another. This is not the end of the world. It's not the vaccine. People, I hear the whole time, the vaccine is going to be the end of the pandemic. Of course not. We don't even know if the vaccine is going to help to all population groups. Some signs we get now is that it will help for one group and not for the other. And then if you have to work with different vaccines, what a logistical nightmare. I mean, the end of the pandemic is the moment that we as a community are going to learn how to live with this pandemic. And it depends on us. And that's a very positive message, that the most cost-effective way whether to tackle COVID or any disease and prevention is to strengthen your primary healthcare. I mean, in some countries, 80% of what's happening in emergency departments, I mean, can be tackled by your family doctor or your nurse, community nurse. Such decisions have to be made on epidemiological and public health data. And in a number of countries, we see that the politics override the scientists. And also in a number of other countries, we see that people are doubting the science. That's very dangerous. I mean, the science, we have to get it right. And it's very difficult. I mean, WHO, you know, also has been blamed a number of times. But, I mean, communicating on something that you don't really know the risk is very, very difficult. And for some, you do too little. For some, you go too far, right? Science, by nature, is slow, is iterative, is repetitive. You have to refute it. I know we are forced, we means WHO and the governments, to make very important policy decisions on incomplete evidence. And that's something new. I mean, also with COVID, the people are vulnerable and prone, and there are many other pandemics. There's a pandemic of chronic disease.